Hi, my name is Sam Johnson and I am a voice teacher. Today I will be reacting to and analyzing Tamino performing Habibi live.
Something hides in every night brings desire from the deep.
Okay, I'm not sure this is live. It probably is, but there I think is some sort of syncing delay or something, because some of the sounds that he's making aren't matching up with what's coming out of his face. But that's okay. He sounds really good. He's got such a cool tone to his voice. The low notes, you just don't hear a lot of guys sing low notes anymore. And so I really respect whenever people do. It's like people joke about Lin-Manuel accidentally bringing back the baritone role to musical theater because for so long, it wasn't really being written for. And the same thing is true with so much pop music. The world seems to really favor people who sing high all the time. So even seeing just a little bit of going down there is really cool.
And though he's not alone, he fears to never love another and leave his heart forever with a smile.
Yeah, it's pretty. It sounds like he's releasing up into more of a lighter coordination, more of a head voice or falsetto when he does that. If I was working with him, the first thing that I'd kind of want to look at is just what his jaw is doing. It seems like every once in a while it wants to go into a slight underbite coordination. If that is just how his body works, that's just how his body works. But it is something to look at and make sure that you can utilize your jaw in as efficient of a way, because oftentimes if we start jutting it forward even just a little bit habitually, that starts introducing tension that can really build up as you sing through a full song or a full practice session or a full performance. Good. So he starts Habibi. And it goes into that smaller place on that third note up. And then on the B, he kind of stays in that headier coordination.
Light is burning as I am burning.
It is very impressive that he's able to do it so smoothly, though, that it's very clearly chest, and then release. That smooth transition is a paramount of what vocal training should aim for. We just want to be able to move back and forth between registers, between different parts of our voice as smoothly as possible, so that if you don't want it to be smooth, you can do it that way too. But like, we want to be able to do both of them, and usually the smoother one is what more people want, so I think that it's a better place to default to, and he does quite a good job with that.
Light is burning as I am yearning.
I mean, to be fair, if your jaw looks like that, you'd probably want to show it off a little bit.
And every time it is recalled, it covers all.
I really love the da. That sounds so good in his voice. He's practiced it a lot, and he just, it's a really cool stylistic thing. I like it a lot, and I love how it sounds with his guitar. Like that little run and what he's doing with the guitar just play well for me. So he's doing a thing that a lot of baritones do when we approach up in that F area, and that's to kind of lock things up, retract the tongue slightly.
He's not doing nearly as much as a lot of people do when we get up into this area.
But it is kind of in that direction. Habibi would be more of the sound if the tongue was more forward.
Habibi
is closer to what he's doing. So playing with how covered it is, how much your tongue is pulling back, you can kind of find these different colors. I don't think that this color works as well for going toward notes higher than about the F or the F sharp, and that's why you see it mostly happen with baritone voices, because if you don't have to sing higher than that, you can get away with doing that. But if you have to jump up and sing a high C or even an A or anything above that with any regularity, doing it like this is gonna really lock things up and make it difficult to go to those higher notes. It's possible, but it does make it harder.
The feeling deep inside you wants to love it all again.
Totally different approach. He goes up to the E, or to the A. It's a higher note. A is higher than E. E, F, G, A. It's a few things higher. A few notes higher than E is A. And that's the one that he did. So listen to how he did that. It was on the E vowel. The exact same E vowel. No, it wasn't the exact same E vowel as he did on the E earlier, because this E vowel was different. He moved his mouth in a different way, and it sounds way clearer. It's that tongue kind of sliding forward versus the pulled back one.
Forget you after one last dance, but you're everywhere. Yes, you are in every melody.
And then that E kind of, yeah, it's back on that F melody. All of those are E, which is the most correct E. They're all useful, but it is very interesting that you can hear that pretty distinct color shift. It's a timbral shift from that F up to the A. And as people learning how to sing, we need to kind of look for wherever our voice has that timbral shift naturally and kind of embrace it, because by doing that, it allows us to not get locked up in needing to sound the same way all the way through our range. If we know that, like, around this E, we can get away with making this more kind of sound, and above that, that we have to go into a slightly different coordination, or it just sounds different to us, that gives us a stronger roadmap to follow when we're actually singing. So he sounds like he knows his voice really well, because if he didn't, it would be much more likely that he would get locked up in the way that he was doing the F, get too heavy, and not make the shift to be able to sing the A in a way that works well on the E vowel and on the A vowel, and he did them both really, really well, I think. Yes, please.
So
with this part, it's very much a different instrument. It's a different quality of sound. Going into that really teeny place versus how he was doing it. If we were aiming for the vocal quality that he was getting on the F below, it would be more like that quality versus that more piercing teeny sound that he's getting. He's doing that by closing the mouth, by letting the larynx rise slightly. Not everyone can do that. Like, there is kind of just a physical quality. You have to also be able to stretch your vocal folds really, really far, like make them very, very teeny to be able to do that. And most of the time, using the larger vocal tract, the larger vowel is going to be more successful when you get up into that area. So again, it's he's doing all of these things because they create a specific sound that people react to. Fresh, it's nice. That light that he was doing up there, light, and the ee, they're kind of pressed sounds. Again, we like that pressed sound. So many of us are very used to hearing a pressed sound from our singers that we associate it with heartbreak, we associate it with intensity, we associate it with emotion. And I think that it's important to recognize that, because if we want to get that quality, but we don't want it to actually be pressed, sometimes we have to make little adjustments, or we can't get away with doing it for a full song. And so we have to just recognize what our voice is capable of. Does the technique that we're doing serve what material that we're doing? Because fitness is only being able to do what you actually need to do, right? So if you're a fit singer, then you need to be able to get through your set. If you're not able to do that, then you need to make some changes. And sometimes that might be how you approach certain sections of it. With him, it seems like he knows them all pretty well. He's jumping back and forth between them, but it doesn't sound like one unified voice to me. And that's a big goal of a lot of people. So if we're determining how good a singer is by if their voice is like a full unified four octaves, there are going to be a lot of people who we probably like that don't really have that consistent sound all the way across. And what I mean by that is on a piano, you can play this note. This is a C. You can play this note. This is also a C. C, C. They're all different pitches, but they all sound like the same instrument. Where with what he did, the quality that he got by adjusting his vocal track for the beep versus the one up here,
beep,
those sound like different instruments. That is a good thing in that if you make it a good thing. It is not a good thing if you don't want it to sound like a bunch of different instruments. So experiment with all of them, because it's important to be able to make a lot of sounds to be a expressive, good singer. I think there is an element of aesthetic bias of, like, you have to recognize when I say I like the singer, I think this is a good singer, some of that is going to be caught up with just how I grew up with music, with my aesthetic bias, and that is fair, and that is okay for me to have. There's also the element that I try to develop in my singers, whether I like them as technical vocalists or not, but the ability to just feel as they are performing and show that feeling so that people can watch them feel things. And if they are able to do that, and they are also able to be technically musicianship good enough, then we get really special performances. With him, like, it looked like he was feeling the whole time. He didn't really open his eyes very much, but on his face, it just looked like he was feeling. The way that he was holding himself, it looked like he was letting himself feel. So you gotta let yourself feel for other people to do that. Otherwise, it becomes a performance. It becomes performative, and I don't really like that as much. Sometimes it's necessary too, but people don't seem to react to it as well. People don't seem to cry when they watch someone who's like, I'm performing, versus someone who's feeling really, really strongly and just letting everyone watch. So well done, Tamino. This aria was beautiful. Your magic guitar is a beautiful thing, and well done. Thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, leave a comment below. Go check out all the links in the description. I've got the best set of links, including a good Twitter link. Ooh, go check that one out. It is unbelievable. You can click it and then like go click some other things. If you also want to just stay on this webpage and click some things down here, there's like a subscribe and a bells. Ring the bells.